It's been a busy week at work in my day job, and I've been eating far too much takeout, so I should finally make this work for me and do a video. Today on Mark Tastes Random Things, it is the Subway Supremo.
Just eat it, eat it. Get yourself an egg and beat it. Have some more chicken, have some more pie. It doesn't matter if it's boiled or fried.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Your old pal Mark Cappis here with another installment of Mark Tastes Random Things. Seems like everything is getting a gritty reboot these days, and the latest to get a gritty reboot is the Subway menu. If you go down to your corner Subway these days, you'll find they have 15 brand new subs on the menu, and they have completely dominated the menu. That's all they have now. That's all they sell. They're bragging about how they've been designed by chefs, and it looks like the customization that was long a Subway hallmark has now been done away with, because they ask you, do you want it as is? Because everything has its own preset list of ingredients. So there we go. Subway is brand new, starting to get more and more like a typical fast food restaurant. So looking at all these new subs, I figured I should try one for a while here on the show. Looking at the Subway menu, my go-to at Subway has always been the Italian BMT, or as they called it back in the 90s when Subway first started bursting onto the scene, the Spicy Italian. So taking a look at the Subway menu, it looks like among their gritty rebooted subs, the closest to the Italian BMT is number 13, the Supremo. I gotta add in the number because they really insist you order by the numbers. So because it was another long day at work and I'm getting takeout once again, I figured let's finally swing by Subway and let's do the Supremo, because I've been busy in my day job, so why not be busy in my night job making videos for you. All right, we have returned from Subway. Let's crack open our wrapped up sandwich here and take a look at the Supremo. There we go. Looks like a typical Subway sub. Open it up there. There's our tasty Italian meats. We got the tomatoes, we got the pickles. Doesn't look too bad. There's onions. As I recall, there's supposed to be banana peppers on this as well, but I'm not seeing any banana peppers. They might have been all out. I know with all these new subs, that's been happening at my local Subways quite a bit. So there we have it, the Subway Supremo. All right, let's tie into the Supremo. Maybe those pickles are banana peppers, because I am getting a slight hint of spice. But all in all, it doesn't taste too dissimilar from my good old Italian BMT. What really makes it taste like the Italian BMT is the house sauce. I always have to have that on the Italian BMT. Way back when Subway first burst onto the scene in the 90s, the house sauce was the only sauce they had. They would ask you if you wanted your sandwich with sauce or without. Then they added like six more, and it went all downhill from there. But the important thing was I had an onion on my belt, which was the style at the time. Nope, those are definitely pickles, not banana peppers. It's not too bad. Tastes enough like my good old Italian BMT. It'll probably be my go-to. I don't typically get onions on the Italian BMT, so that's probably the little bit of heat I'm tasting. All in all, it's not too bad. Yep, it's got a nice blend of meats. The onions give it just the right amount of spice. If they actually had banana peppers and put those on, it would probably have just a perfect amount of heat. This one might be the subject of a do-over at a later date. So there we have it. The new Supremo sub from Subway. Tastes just like enough like the good old Italian BMT that it'll probably be my new go-to. Wow. I'm doing my wrap-up here and I'm finally getting some of the heat in the back of my throat. Maybe it's some of the new meats they've got on there providing that spice. The fact that it's kicking in when I'm trying to do my wrap-up really tells you what kind of a slow burn it is. Anyways, the Subway Supremo, it's got the heat that hits you after the fact, but still tastes enough like my good old Italian BMT that this will probably be my new standard at Subway.